Russia's grain deal exit is a stab in the back, Kenya.
Here's a summary of the article.
Russia's withdrawal from the deal allowing Ukraine to safely export grain through the Black Sea is a stab on the back for those in drought-hit countries, Kenya's government has said. Grain prices also soared, but the deal, brokered in July 2022 by Turkey and the UN, allowed vital Ukrainian produce back on the world market. The decision by Russia to exit the Black Sea Grain Initiative is a stab on the back at global food security prices and disproportionately impacts countries in the Horn of Africa already impacted by drought, Korir Singoe, a minister in Kenya's Foreign Affairs Ministry, said in a tweet. Russia said that Ukraine's failure to export more grain to poorer countries was one of the reasons it pulled out of the deal. The grain deal is important as Ukraine is one of the world's largest exporters of sunflower, maize, wheat and barley. Nikolai Gorbachev, the president of the Ukrainian Grain Association, told the BBC that his members had identified alternative means of exporting grain, including through its Danube River ports. Mr. Peskov said Russia letting the deal expire was unrelated to the attack.
This post received a score of 4,500, with an upvote ratio of 97%. Here are the top comments in response to this article.
Maybe Africa, the various governments therein, will start to get the message that Russia is not some anti-imperial savior or honest broker. One can only hope.
Russia's goal is to eliminate Ukraine as a grain supplier so that Russia controls the grain market that much more. Any country who wants grain at a decent price will be forced to kiss the ring. Russia will insist that these countries pressure Ukraine to the negotiating table for whatever terrible deal Russia now decides to offer. Russia is happy to use global food scarcity as a weapon.
Ukraine can still ship by land to Romania or Bulgaria and ship from there, assuming Russia won't attack Romanian or Bulgarian ships, or via Poland and access the Baltic Sea. It's not like all Ukraine grain is lost.
It's not lost, but won. The capacity to transport grains by train or trucks is limited, adding more costs too. Delays in the schedule will fuck up a lot of things, adding more costs. 3. Those costs are translated to prices in the market, so more people will eat less or not at all.
You forgot about the Danube.
Shipping down rivers requires a completely different set of equipment than shipping across the sea. The Danube also takes you in the wrong direction if your goal is to get to Africa and South Asia, who account for a big chunk of Ukrainian grain purchases.
You know, I remember a time not so long ago when it was impossible, simply impossible, for Germany to survive without Russian natural gas. I mean, all the sensible people knew it. And then, one day, it was suddenly possible, like magic, ship it on the damn river. If this is hard, ask the people who figured out how Germany could survive without Russian gas. This isn't the time for incrementalism and organically adapting free market economics. It's a fucking war.
Hard lesson to learn, that's how Russia does business, a stab in the back with a twist.
I mean, find me one country outside of the continent that goes into Africa with a purely fair and benevolent goal in mind.
So because no one is perfect, you think lumping Russia with the rest is appropriate? At least with the current US, you know what you are getting. We usually just want to make lucrative trade deals and remove potential terrorist threats.
If you want an in-depth discussion, go read work by Walter Rodney or Kwame Nkrumah about colonialism and neocolonialism. We can get into the weeds about every individual foreign influence in Africa, and many folks have taken the time to do so, but by no means is the US an entity on the right side of engaging with Africa and has not been. It's not an issue of no one is perfect, it's an issue of most states outside of Africa are more than happy to create an exploitative relationship with the continent and often desire it. Long story short, Russia is one of many countries promising support in Africa with one hand while holding a knife in the other.
This video was automatically created by Reddit to Speech. The article and comments in this video were selected from Reddit according to their upvotes, and any paraphrasing was performed by smmry.com, without any human intervention.